Redditors who are married to Karens, how is it like? None of them are on here. They are on shared Facebook accounts named Karndav Smith. Underscore this exploded more than I could imagine. Thanks for the awards and my first gold underscore. My mom is a literal Karen. As in, it's her name. But she's like a bizarro Karen. She will constantly ask to speak with managers and supervisors and bosses. But when said managers arrive, she unloads about the employee helping her out was fantastic. Hardworking and friendly. And then Shell spent 20 minutes trying to figure out if she and the manager know someone in common. 9 times out of 10 they do. As a kid it would embarrass me. As an adult it's one of my favorite things about her. She makes people feel good about the work they do and it's really special to watch how wonderful she makes people feel. Plus she's got long gorgeous silver hair. Not married to a Karen. But married someone with a Karen for a sister. Syl is the freaking worst. I hate more than anything going out to dinner with her. Listening to her order food and talk to the servers. Holidays are also terrible. She sends out long lists of expected gifts list. She celebrates every holiday and birthday specifically for presents even when it's not appropriate. Funny thing is one time I was away from the dinner table when the bill came and Syl waited for me to return to pay the bill by actually handing it to me. She didn't give it to her sibling slash my so or pay her half. But expressly handed it to me to pay. BTW. Her husband is an idiot and they are a match made in heaven. My sister is a Karen. Everyone feels so sorry for her husband. Everything is his fault. He is treated like a slave. She only addresses him by yelling. She constantly insults him. We have no idea why he hasn't divorced her or flipped out and attacked her. We have all told her to cool it and her response is that he's just so stupid. I could go on and on but my sister really is a horrible person. Not married to one. But mom was a major Karen back when I was growing up. Mom, can we just go? Was my favorite question. Then the apologetic nod as we leave the store. I know a couple with a Karen. She blamed him for everything. The husband was, in our opinion, something of a saint. Once she broke a glass in the kitchen. Came and sat back down at the table. And said that was your fault. We all just stared at her. She looked sheepish and said I knew that one probably wouldn't work. They are divorced. Now. I guess even saintliness has its limits. My husband's ex is Karen. She's a classic narcissist. When one of our feral hens started acting aggressive towards other hens, my stepson named her Karen. My mom's a Karen. She is self-aware she is a Karen. My siblings and I send her memes about it. When my stepdad divorced her last summer, we were all amazed he lasted 17 years to be honest. None of us like going out with her, it's terrible, and my husband just straight up tells her no, you aren't talking to the manager when we go in a place. I'll tell you guys a story my step told us. They are farmers and own a small beef and bee farm. They have a store they go to for bee supplies. The owner called my stepdad and asked him to please be the one to pick up their stuff because his staff was tired of dealing with my mom. He is the only one who went to the store for the next 5 years. My mom is a Karen. She thinks the world is supposed to cater to her. Serve her and everyone else is wrong. Once we went to Carl's Jr. She ordered 4 burgers. For the 4 of us. She pulls one out of the bag while the guy is getting our drinks and hides it. She complains that he forgot a burger. She pulls them out one by one and counts it in front of him. It's obviously missing because she hid it and he's swearing up and down he put them all in the bag. I'm stunned speechless and it happened so fast. She got a free burger. And laughed as we drive off. I'm just staring at her and she opens it up to eat it on the drive home. And she ate her actual burger like the 5th one never existed. I can't even explain how she is when she's in the hospital. She treats it like a luxury stay in a hotel. I knew from the beginning that there would be difficulties but I love her and made the leap to make her my forever partner. Yes. Her attitude towards certain people and things confused me at times. But by keeping an open mind and accepting her for who she was. Everything has worked out well. We've been married for 10 years. We have a darling daughter. And I've even come to love my wife's kimchi fried rice. I taught my nephews, ages 9 and 11, about Karens last year when they stayed with us for a week after school let out. After describing traits and observing them in the wild, they asked somewhere around day 2, "Is our mom a Karen?" My reply, "You words, not mine. Married to one. She doesn't get why people think Karens complain so much. It's annoying for her and she'd like to talk to someone about this. Not married to one, but my mom is absolutely one. I spend most of my time with her in public apologizing to people after she's walked away. The one and only time it comes in handy is when I've bought cars and had her come in during the price negotiation phase. She's knocked off thousands purely due to how unpleasant she is and how much people want her to just get the hell out of the door. My ex-wife is a Karen. In every sense but name. It was always so embarrassing. She was incapable of treating anyone like a human for the most trivial of occurrences. It was hell for me. As a person that's pretty forgiving and don't seek out confrontation. So in a one-word description it was hell. LOLP. S. She's very codependent and jumps from relationship to relationship these days. Not surprised. My life has been a living hell. The number of times I have had to intervene to save the life of a customer service rep over nickels is insane. I've asked for divorce now just a couple weeks ago. Guess how that went over? Engaged to one. She was raised as a princess by her military raised father. However, she's super down to earth, but God forbid you work in the service industry and mess something up. She worked at IHOP during college, so it humbled her compared to her family. She just writes reviews now, good or bad, and emails corporate to complain. If something is wrong with my food, she refuses me to sit there and eat it. Which I hate, but I have gotten her better about it, I believe. So maybe she is just a recovering Karen at this point. Divorced an abusive Karen who was convicted of domestic violence, that's a misdemeanor, folks. So she got half of everything. Totally worth it. My life before was a nightmare. Escape was priceless. Note. If you are in a similar situation, especially now what with coronavirus quarantines, and need someone to talk to, PM me. My mother is a Karen. If something minor inconveniences her, she blows it up into a huge dun. Constantly complains, belittles me and has a slight superiority complex. I read that as Koreans and was thoroughly confused and amused by this thread. I'll see myself out. I'm not married to a Karen, but someone in my family decided to make a Karen family, and let me just say, it is freaking hell. I do not go to any social event if said Karen will be there, keeps the peace in my family TBH, nor do I go alone with Karen. She is a nightmare to everyone in her path. From car guards to cashiers. Even her friends. No one can be better than her or smarter than her, and she's just freaking exhausting, man. The worst part is, her kids are becoming just like her. People who are married to Karens are the guy equivalent of Karens, or they are aloof goofs unaware that their Karen is a Karen. You won't get a real answer. My mom is a bit of a Karen. And we're pretty much no contact now, so that should tell you everything you need to know. Whenever we'd go out to eat, it's always too cold. They don't have the brand of sparkling water she likes. They've put ice in her drink when she didn't want it. She always has to make some kind of modification to her order, etc. The list goes on. It got to the point where if we were out shopping and she said she needed to return something, I'd just go somewhere else because I couldn't stand watching her be rude and argue with the staff. My parents are divorced and I live with my dad now instead. Part of the reason I barely see my mom is because I'd have to meet her in public, go for a coffee or something, and I just can't deal with the way she behaves in these places, so I don't go. My mom is a Karen. Literally. Her name is Karen. But she is like a complete angel. So selfless. So loving. So pure. I have never met anyone who has the heart she does. I swear I think she is just an angel God placed on this earth. Ick. Anyway. She is pretty upset about this Karen thing going on. She doesn't understand why people are attacking her. She thinks she's been nice to everyone. And she has. She's amazing. But she doesn't understand why this is a thing. She would like to kindly request that we change Karen to Susan, and I agree. She doesn't deserve a meme about her. Her heart is too pure. Obligatory not married to a Karen. However, my mother is a Karen, and Lord, is it not easy. I don't even know how many times I've had to correct her on the way she speaks to servers. Doesn't listen. The smallest inconvenience. She wants to talk to someone higher up. She overreacts to every inconvenience and is the type to try and bargain at a retail store. Apparently the concept of set price does not apply to her. Can't stand it. I'm glad I no longer live with my parents. I love my mother, I do, and she has great qualities, but she is the most Karen a Karen can be. I'm divorcing a Karen, nothing was ever good enough. Everything had to be the most expensive thing, and even then it wasn't good enough. It was exhausting and it sucked the passion I had for life out of me. Kind of a funny story. Note before reading, I am a male. So I ordered a pizza. This was way before the COVID days. They said 30 minutes. An hour goes by. No pizza. Due to a fault on their end and their attitude, I went off on them. My 10-year-old son heard me, and after I hung up, he says, "Dad, why do you have to be such a Karen?"